What is up, guys? It's your boy, Rick, insect-like chattering. Cacus here. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. Make sure to hit that like and subscribe button to support the channel, and let me know what you think my next intro name to be. That comment section is out of control. Guys, today we are going to be taking a look at genuinely one of the best auto rifles that Destiny 2 has ever seen. And I think you could make the argument that this is the best 720 archetype auto rifle in the game right now. It's the Chroma Rush Legendary Kinetic Auto Rifle. Now, this weapon was added with Season of the Splicer, and it's available from doing Expunge missions like the chests at the end, as well as override activities, and you can focus engrams to try to get this weapon. Now, the first thing we need to do is take a look at this weapon's stats. And the thing that stands out to me right away is that the Chroma Rush has incredible base stability. To put this into perspective, another 720 auto that a lot of people have fond memories of, the Steel Feather Repeater back from Season of Dawn, that had a starting stability of 38. So that shows you just how great the Chroma Rush's stability is, and that gives it a pretty big intrinsic advantage. But speaking of advantages, another one is that this weapon has higher than normal aim assist. Almost every other rapid fire auto has 75 or lower aim assist, and this clocks in at 80. So it's a really easy to use, user friendly package right out of the gate. But let's move on now and talk about this weapon's perks. So, starting things off, we have a pretty normal assortment of barrels. However, because the base stability is so high, you're really going for barrels that increase the range. That's going to matter especially in PvP. However, if you want a great barrel overall, something like small bore that increases both is fantastic. But moving on to the second category of perks, we do have, speaking of range increases, accurized rounds, giving you a straight plus 10. But if you're more PvE minded, something like appended mag or extended mag may be what you're looking for. We do have steady rounds, but I believe this is unnecessary, and then we have a couple of reload speed increasing perks at the end. But moving on from there, we have the first main perk category, and we start here with a brand new one, heating up. Final blows with this weapon increase accuracy and stability while improving vertical recoil. This can be fantastic, making this weapon basically a laser beam after getting a kill. We do have feeding frenzy, where kills will increase the reload speed, stacks up to 5 times. We have subsistence, which got a massive buff, no longer reducing your carried ammo capacity. This just gives you rounds back in your magazine for getting a kill based on the overall magazine size. So subsistence plus something like appended or extended mag is absolutely a wombo combo. Then we've got dynamic straight reduction, improving the accuracy as you continually hold the trigger. We've got moving target, which increases your strafe speed. And lastly, we have another new one, tunnel vision, kind of like heating up, but instead it increases your target acquisition and aim down sight speed. Now, in the second perk category, we start things off with two fantastic damage increasing perks. We firstly have kill clip, giving you around a 30% damage bonus after you get a kill. Then we have Rampage, which stacks up to about a 30% damage bonus at Rampage times 3 after getting 3 rapid kills. Then we've got Adrenaline Junkie, a new one where a grenade final blow will give you bonus damage. We have Wellspring, where getting kills gives your abilities back. And then we have Tap the Trigger to increase the accuracy on the initial trigger pull, kind of like the opposite of Dynamic Sway Reduction. And we end things off with Thresh, where kills give you more super energy. Okay, so those are the possible perk spawns for the Chroma Rush, but what are you looking for in terms of a god roll? Well, let's start with a PvP god roll, because the Chroma Rush and its incredible stats has actually slotted itself in as a part of the PvP meta. It's not necessarily top tier, but you will see this from time to time in the Crucible. So I think firstly, you really want a barrel that increases your range. So something like hammer-forged rifling is fantastic, a straight range increase, no downsides. However, small bore is not bad, but extended barrel is actually pretty good as well. That's gonna control your recoil too, but honestly, full bore, giving the biggest range increase of plus 15, but a stability negative of minus 10 is actually a pretty good choice here as well, simply because that starting range is so good, it can take a little bit of a hit. Moving on from there, you probably want something like accurized rounds to further increase the range, and then I think you're going for two different choices. Firstly, you do have heating up. This is going to be higher risk, but higher reward. You need to get that first kill, but if you do, you're off to the races. But a more consistent choice that accomplishes a similar thing is dynamic spray reduction. You're not gonna need a kill, it's gonna activate pretty soon after you start firing, and it is going to significantly improve the accuracy of your weapon. Then, in that second category, I think you're really going for one of the two damage increasing perks, kill clip or rampage. It really depends on simply which one you want to use. If you are using kill clip, you probably will have to stack a bunch of reload speed increasing perks so you can get that bonus active as quickly as possible. Rampage, the damage bonus comes a little bit easier. You can get a kill and then kill another guy in that same magazine size. Very possible, trust me, I've done it, but you don't get quite as big of a damage bonus. Another alternative is actually tap the trigger. If you just want full accuracy, absolute laser beam weapon, that's what you're going for. But I think the bigger payoff is one of the damage increasing perks. However, it is time to move off of PvP and talk about PvE. What is the god roll you're going for there? Well, here, range is definitely not as important. Something like hammer-forged rifling is still gonna be good because there's no downsides, but I would stay away from something like full bore because there, the stability negative is just not worth the extra 5 range, right? And honestly, the best one for PvE would be small bore increasing both. But moving on from there, I'm actually gonna skip ahead to the final perk slot because there's really two different god rolls with this weapon. One involves kill clip and one involves rampage. If you're getting kill clip, you definitely want to have the reload speed increasing perks like flared magwell or potentially alloy magazine. But if you're getting rampage, you want to extend that magazine, you don't want to be reloading, so you want something like appended mag or extended mag. Similarly, that same choice factors into our first perk slot. If you're getting kill clip, you absolutely want feeding frenzy to increase your reload speed. Feeding frenzy plus kill clip has been a wombo combo for years in Destiny 2, and it's still fantastic. But if you are going for rampage, feeding frenzy is actually still going to be quite good with rampage, but I think the better choice is going to be subsistence, right? You're getting kills, you're increasing your damage, you're getting ammo directly back into your magazine. You can negate the need to reload at all with this weapon. Now, the only other thing I want to mention is that because this weapon is so easy to use, has such great stats, you may want to use something like either feeding frenzy or subsistence and combine them with Wellspring simply to get more abilities, or Thresh to get more super. Now, that's not going to be as good at killing adds, but that could be a key component in a certain build you may want to run. If you want to get your super all the time, if your build is based on your super, heck, subsistence, Thresh, Chroma Rush is going to slap. Same things with Wellspring if you have an abilities focused build. And so guys, that is it for the video. I hope you enjoyed and found this interesting. If you did, please remember to help me out by simply rating and especially sharing this video. If you guys want to see more Destiny 2 content similar to this, don't be afraid to slap that subscribe button. If you want to get in touch with me and keep up to date with the latest channel activity, the best way is to follow me on Twitter at @RickKakis. That is linked in the description down below. Again, I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, have a good day.